You're gonna stick around for a bit. But just messing with this guy real quick up front. I mean, those of you that watch Aris other streams already know that he has a ton of fucking range. And he could punish stuff that other characters can't punish. For example, a shadow block Heihachi forward forward two. Right? Right, so no matter how far away he blocks us from, he could always punish it with that. But unless he's from max range, he could actually punish it with a down forward two in most instances. Right? See, that's the only time you cannot. But you always get forward one plus two. It's pretty sick. So like, no matter what character you're fighting against, you have access to some really good whiff punishers. And of course, forward 2, but forward 2 is a lot slower. I don't know how much slower, but I know it's slower than forward 1 plus 2, that's for sure. Like, if I were to... See? That doesn't block punish that. 16, negative 16, I think? Yeah, that's negative 16. So a 15 free spirit thrust will always punish that, so that's pretty fucking good. Just up front. The only thing I don't like is, despite the range of this stuff, depending on how real this lance spear to the foot is, if it's sealable or is it not sealable, that's the big question. It's gonna take time to determine that, but if this really isn't sealable, then he's a threat from this range, basically. Always. A high risk threat, but he's always a threat from this range. Which is pretty damn cool. I'll lower this just a little bit here. Yeah. Alright. So now that I know that. I need to check what's zero on block for him. If he has a zero on block move or zero on hit move. Once I find zero, I could work from there to find out all of his frame data for sure. Because I know people have been making spreadsheets, but I like to do my own shit. Speaking of, I should open a Word document. Let me minimize this for a second. Start typing up all this bullshit. I know everybody's compiling their own data, but I like to be sure by checking my own work. Alright. Obvious, right? Oh yes, alright. Move space. Alright. I'm gonna save this to the desktop. Just label it Noctis Beta. So here's what I'm gonna do. Let me see if I can capture this. Let me see. Would a game capture allow me? No, it won't work. Oh, it would work. Let's see, does this work? No, it froze. Huh. Yeah, no, it doesn't capture that. Alright, delete that. Let's see if there's a way to capture this text document. Whatever. Fuck it. Let me just shrink this shit. Alright, so the first things first. Once I find what's zero on block or on hit for him, I could switch over to a character whose frame data I know. And then I could break it down. A lot of people already know the startup on a lot of his moves. What I don't think they know is the data on block outside of the big stuff, right? But like... Oh wow, what's his two? He doesn't have a two jab. Oh shit, he doesn't have a two jab. Fuck. Well, actually, we still do a one jab. I'm sure a one jab is still plus one on block, right? Alright, a couple things I want to test up front, though. Okay. Alright, Alright, so Noctis could punish his own bullshit, but I feel like most characters, if you space this out well, and what I've been seeing Anakin doing with this, with that low, is he does it after juggles that leave people like just far away. So if they were to tech and block this, they'll be like back here, and then most of their while standing punishes him with. Which is pretty slick. And then if they get up mashing, he could juggle off of that, right? I don't know what the... What's the follow-up to that? Wow. He has some sort of follow-up to that. I don't know what it is. Alright. No. Down back 1 plus 2. Thank you. Oh, what's going on, dude? There it is. Is that the only follow-up? I mean, that's good damage, still. That's good damage. Even though it's not a juggle, that's really good damage. Alright. What's that on block? Okay, so negative 17 at least. Oh my god, that is awful on block. You saw that shit? That shit punished? Yeah, ooh, that is awful on block. Holy shit. As expected. See, that's the thing, you know. I think most of the cast will be able to punish this, just some of them will have to dash first. But he seems so bad that, like, let me test something. Yeah, if you can just dash in. What if I dash into the dot forward too? See, most people will get dash in 15 frame hop kick, right? No, no. So let me try to pick somebody with shit range like Kazumi. I know I'm one of like a billion people doing this and I'm late to the party here, but welcome to the King of I like checking my own work. Tournament 7. Kazumi Noctis Lucis Kylum. Oh, this coffee came out bad. I feel like I haven't had a good cup of coffee in forever, man. Ugh. Man, I really hate his design. Alright. Right, so. Let me just jab first. Right. Wow, it doesn't push back, right? I thought it would push back for some reason. Alright. Yeah, he gotta be ready for it. But he gotta. Alright. But there is a spacing that will make this really difficult to get a big punish off for most characters, right? So, one thing I want to look into is if there's any sort of juggle ender that will leave him in the perfect spacing. So, if somebody were to tech, they would block that at the tip of the spear. And make that, I guess, safer. If not completely safe. Man, he doesn't have a two jab, he doesn't have a crouch jab from standing. Nah, that's going to make things weird. Alright, I can stick with this group. Alright, so I'm gonna start from the top, right? And starting from the top is 1-2-2. Right? And then, so 1-2-2 is 27 damage, high. I know it doesn't jail. 27 damage. 10 frame punisher. Right? Question is, how much is it on hit? Right? Alright, let's see if it's plus 5. I don't know if that crest is high, but we'll find out. Okay. Was I slow? So it's definitely plus. Just making sure. 13, right? Oh boy. Plus one? Yikes. That sucks. Plus one on hit, huh? Whack. Whack, whack, whack. Plus one on hit. At least the damage is alright. It's not safe, right? This is negative 12, I think, right? Oh, 11, huh? Yeah, negative 11 on block. Alright, 10 frame Punisher. Okay, so this 1-2 does jail, right, at the very least. So it's not like some weird geese shit with 1-1-2 where you can duck the second jab. And there's no counter hit properties on that last hit, right? Nope, nothing. So just don't even bother with this shit in the neutral unless you confirm a whiff punish during a sidestep or something. But keep this to block punishing or up close. Ugh, gross. Alright. That shit sucks. Duck last hit. Okay, next. That's 1-2. 1-1-2. Wait, 1-1-2? That was 1-2-2. Alright, so what's 1-1-2? Oh no, I'm looking at Kazumi. I'm a fucking idiot. I'm sorry, guys. That was 1-2-2. There it is. 1-2, 1+2. Okay, this is the one that you could, is safe, but you could interrupt them, right? Yeah, if it's not safe, it's like, who's gonna punish it, right? But you could interrupt with Magic 4, which is probably the ideal way, or exchange with 12 frames, which is not a good way to go by. So interrupt with jab or Magic 4 to a juggle, right? No counter hit properties, it just does a shitload of damage. Can't she sidestep it? Because of that gap, though, you can sidestep block, so... Oh, whoa, okay. Sidestep left. Oh, wow. No camera tricks there. Okay, that's guaranteed. Does that last hit do a tailspin? It do, okay. So, 1-2, 1+2. High, mid. Right. 15+23. Damage. Hard to test how much this is on block, but it's safe. Knockdown hits. Interrupt last hit with I10 or I11. Okay, next. Yeah, so that's there to like mix up if you're 1-2-2, but I forgot I'm doing this in reverse now. Yeah, that's there to mix up with the 1-2-2 for people that duck it, but, you know, whatever. I don't like that kind of thing. Like, it's weak jab pressure. I like when the options attached to 1-2 jabs are strong. So, like, they're real deterrents. Like, that last hit, 12 damage, you know, that's not a real deterrent. And, like, there's no real reason to respect that lasted so much. Even though, you know, it's a nice chunk of damage and it's safe, it's like, that's not going to stop people from mashing because you're still going to get jabbed, you know? Or mashing forward out of your jab pressure, you know? The whole idea is to stop people from pressing anything, like a Brian 1-2-1 or a Shaheen 1-2-2, which is unsafe, but at the very least, on counter hit, he gets a juggle for it, you know? So this is just kind of like gimmicky shit. I don't know. Not good. All right, next we got the dodge stuff. All right, so how does this work? How does this evade? Is this a good evade or a shitty evade? All right. You know what? Let's go left. Okay. It looks cool. So first, test the homie, because of course the homie is going to work, right? Nice. Okay, so that actually, Kazumi's down forward one actually does track a little bit to her right. This is a little bit better than just a sidestep, right? Because if you were just to do like a 1-2 sidestep, right? It'll do better than a sidestep. Alright. Yeah, see? So it's better. It's better than just doing a sidestep, that's for sure. But it's slower on the recovery. So if I were to whiff, oh, he recovers crouching. Okay, he recovers crouching. I didn't know that. Let's do a wall steady for them. Okay. Ooh. Okay, let's see what happens. Oops. Oh, I can still block that. Okay, but if I were to commit to the second hit. Okay. He is. So you know what's interesting about this right now? When I swing off axis. Like, I definitely, if I swing right away, if I swing after the 1-2, see, I'm completely off axis. Like, my attack doesn't realign at all, right? And since he does recover crouching, I know that he has a full crouch low. So this might not be all gimmick, right? This might be something that will get the... Alright, so here we go. We might have a setup for 1-2, 1+2 now. Because to hit him out of this teleport, if you bait them to attacking you, they would have to do something like relatively slow. And that's where the 1-2, 1+2 might catch them. At the very least, they'll have to block it. It might not really hit people too often, but you know, it does. People have to be at least aware of that, I feel. It still seems, we're still like, I still feel like we're on the gimmicky side here though, rather than legit. Let's go right. You know what? Let's go with, what's going on, Seduce here? By the way, guys, check it out. Check it out in the chat. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, the second one. Oh, the second one didn't work? Oh, no, I typed it wrong. Yeah. The regular one, the first one, is way better. The second one, you can't even tell it's Marduk. Alright. So, I want to record him going the other way. Let's go with a while standing one. I think it's 13 frames. Right. Okay, I thought he hit me in the side. So yeah, you could definitely dash up. But can you... if I were to dash up, can I punish that? Look at that. Yeah. Oof. Okay, you have to do like slight micro dash or realign. Yeah, maybe a little delay. There's a delay. Yeah, a little delay. But the delay is, like I said, that's what would set up the 1+2 under. Yes, Terra's theme, indeed. I made a little Final Fantasy playlist because I felt like it would be appropriate, but it was taking way too long. That's actually, I would have been streaming earlier, but I was like there just going through a bunch of old Final Fantasy songs. Alright, so we're learning. I know some of you probably already know a lot of this stuff, but you know. Maybe I'll find something that everybody else missed. Don't know. So, 1-2-3 and 1-2-4. It's up in the air whether it's gimmicky or not, but even if it's not, like, I don't know. What would have made it good is if 1-2-1 plus 2 had counter hit properties. That would have made it good, in my opinion. At the very least, like a free follow up, but we don't even have that, so it's like, eh. I mean, you know. It might be something I'll abuse on somebody every once in a while if they don't know the matchup, or probably get abused on me because I won't know the fucking matchup, but, you know. Worth knowing that you can chase that down pretty well. Alright, so next. Looking at Kazumi's move list. I haven't done this since Geese came out. Good, doing this backwards. Alright. Blitz Rush. Okay, so this is a weird ass string, right? The first of which are natural, right? I know that much. This is like a Soul Calibur string. Right? Yeah, the first two hits are natural. Okay, and the first two hits are safe. So he has a safe mid. That's like a Sophidia string, right? Isn't it? Isn't that Sophidia or like Pyro, one of them? Or Lizard Man? One of them has that Soul Calibur where you press BB and they do like the overhead and the stab. Alright, is it. Can I sidestep? No, that keeps me stuck in place. Even if I try to sidestep, it won't let me. So it pretty much jails. Like, yeah, I can't even mash to get hit by the second hit. So that basically jails, which I get it's weird to hear that, even though there's no high. But basically, I can't do... It's impossible once you block the first hit to get hit by the second hit. That's what I'm saying. Can you delay it? You sure can. That might be important. Ah, see? Now. And I still can't sidestep it. And it's still safe. Now, the reason I'm wondering that is because... Okay, no. The second hit on counter hit does not set up the rest. That sucks. It would have been nice. Yeah. It would have been nice if it at least made the follow-up hit combo. Alright, whatever. Yeah, that just sucks. This thing is shitty. But whatever, let's go through the whole thing. We have another hit. Okay, there it is. Okay, let's see if I can sidestep if I were to block. Okay, no sidestepping. Unless you duck. Okay, so there's no gap. And what is it on block? Alright. Keeps you standing. Oh man, do I have a 14 frame move? What's a 14 frame move for Kazumi? Oh shit. I don't know what a 14 frame move is. What? Anybody know a 14 frame move for Kazumi? I don't remember what off the top of my head. What I do know is negative 13, not negative 15. So the only gap here I have is 14 frames. There it is. I think that's 14. I think. Up 4-2. Okay. Let's see something. Okay, so if that first high counter hits, the rest of it combos. So it does have a sort of bootleg use. But you cannot delay the second until the third hit. You can only delay the first two hits. So I guess you can kind of fissure it just by doing the first two hits. And then back it off, and then all of a sudden you finish it. Right? I don't think that's worth it personally, because how much damage is it, right? You get 30 damage. Nah, that ain't worth it, but you could do that if you want. Mid, high, mid, right? Negative 14 block. Down hits on the last hit. Third hit kind of hit makes NCC. Right. Any follow up? Seems like the low might be guaranteed. Yeah. Is there any pickups? Yeah, right. All right, that's guaranteed. What if I stay down? Is down forward 314 frames. Alright, hold on. Nope. Are you talking about for Kazumi? If you're talking about for Kazumi, this isn't really gonna tell me, but actually, you know what'll tell me? Why did we exchange? What the fuck? Oh, okay. I was about to say I was slow there. All right. So if it's 14, ah, what do you know? Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. Thank you. Up forward 2 might be awesome. Yeah, so up forward 2 and down forward 3 are 14 frame moves to test. Thank you. Alright, cool. So you go, if you were to hit it all, I guess you could make this guaranteed, because if they stay down, the second hit will hit them by itself. Either way, it'll leave Noctis and Crouch right in front of him, which he has a full Crouch mix-up. Not a particularly scary one, because this is this dookie-ass low here, which only gives him the dragon off down 2 counter hit effect. But, you know. We'll get there. 3, down plus 1. That was down 1, right? Woo! Yes, it is. Okay, good. Hop sort of swear it's better than Claudio's hop kick. You mean up forward 2? The orbital? Or are you talking about the running 1 plus 2? Alright, so 2-2 forward 2. Ah, he has a mid option. Okay, here we go. How good is this? Okay, we got a spin effect on it, 27 damage. Okay. Negative 14, huh? Make sure. Okay, yeah, negative 14. 2, 2, 4 plus 2. Right, so this one is Mid, right? 41. negative 14. Fuck. Alright. Spin. Spin on a hit. Not enough delay. Okay. How about now? Damn, how much delay do I have to put? That had to be enough, alright. Okay. Still nothing on the third hit. I was hoping if the second hit counter hits the third hit with combo. Unfortunately, none of that. Okay, tailspin. Cool. So that third hit always has that little bit of delay in there. So you can't really delay yourself. You can only delay the first two hits though. Which seems goofy to me, but whatever. What's the first hit like on block? So it's actually punishable. So don't do it unless it's the, alright. Kazumi's 1-2-2 is... Okay, 13 frame startup. So 2 is 13 frame startup. What's going on, Snuggles? Is this song in game though? No, it's not. I'm playing the Final Fantasy VII music on the side. Hop sword, as far as hell. Oh, you mean as far as being evasive? Maybe. I'll link the playlist. It's just a bunch of random old FF songs. But if you wanna hear it, I don't know if this link will work, but you can try it. I agree, it would be awesome if it were in the game. I mean, the Final Fantasy 15 music isn't particularly terrible. Alright, let's see. How evasive is this? Oh, I back dash first. Let me, Okay, high crush for sure. Okay, so the crush window is a little tight. You go, oh man. Weird. It worked the first time. He crushed it before. Alright, it's a little weird. This is gonna be one of those where if you space it, you'll avoid a lot of shit. But I wanna just throw this out in the neutral because it's awful on block, right? Wow, that whiffed on him? By the way, I forgot to check. Wow, his 1-2 is negative 2 on block. It's not negative 1. because 1-2 is actually worse on block than most others. Maybe I was slow. Let me record it again. Unless it's down forward 1, it's not 13 frames. Okay, it is. Okay, it is. So yeah, his 1-2 is negative 2 on block. Alright, no biggie. Alright, we got a warp strike. Here we go. First one. This is a special mid, so you can block it standing or ducking. Right? It doesn't matter if you duck or not. You'll still block it. Yeah, this is safe. Fuck. Oh, it's not safe. Okay. I thought it would go under highs, to be honest with you guys. Alright, let's see if it's negative 11. Alright. Yeah, negative 11. He was getting mad hyped. Alright. So now we got 2-2, back plus 2. Mid, mid, special mid. Alright. Let's test the, I doubt this is gonna combo, but whatever. Yeah, no way in hell is that gonna get enough to combo. Yeah, I didn't think so. Frozen Zerker, what's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Hey, everybody! How's it going? Yeah, he seems cool. I'm excited to play him, so, you know? He seems interesting. It'll be nice to have a character with some gimmicky shit. Be the one playing the character with the gimmicky shit for once. Alright, that's 18? Wait, I'm looking at the wrong person. It's a 20, 25 damage. Alright. 18 plus 25. This stuff isn't even important, the damage, but whatever. I'm typing it in here too. Negative 11 on block. Alright. What happens when he hits you with this? What's the Oki like after this? Let's have a look-see. Oops. I don't know if it's the same as that, so let me not get ahead of myself. Actually. Whatever. Right. So let's see how this goes. What the? Oh, did I fuck it up? I did. Alright. Going to the stab. Boom, right? Oh yeah, she got the punish there. Huh, not that bad. But if I stay down, I get hit. There's no tech. That is a hard knockdown, though. Let's try this. Yeah, thought so. Okay, not that good. Can't get up and really float, huh? Like, play a magic for wake up for. So, I like that his orbital hits grounded, though. That makes it, even though it's slow and you can get a wake up mid kick, it's probably gonna hit you fairly often out of it. It's just one of those that'll cover you for people who wake up low kick and people who stay down, right? For a nice chunk of damage, too. So up forward, too, right? Boom, right? 16 damage. Nice little chunk of damage to catch people staying on the floor. Alright, I'll explore the Oki in this further later. I don't think he gets anything for free on a grounded opponent. They're too far. Dextra Edge. Stupid name. This is for juggles only, I think. Actually, no, it's not. This is... Let's jab into it. This is a Punisher, right? 12 frame? No. Yeah, 12 frame? Yeah. 12 frame Punisher. Or maybe not 12 frame, maybe 13. No, 12 frame. Yeah, that's a 12 frame Punisher. It is high. So let's see here. But this is okay, but he kicks really high. He kicks like really fucking high. That's gonna mess with the range. Alright. I forgot to test the tracking. Oh my god, that's awful. You saw how linear that second hit was? Oh my god. Oh, that is awful. If you go left, this shit loses hard. Holy shit. You don't even need to walk. I feel like a lot of other strings are like this. You would need to like walk to avoid the second hit. Here you just step and you're like, whatever, whiff up that way, dumbass, you know? Okay, negative 14 again. Common, this is common. 14, huh? Alright. What's up, Milo? Noctis is super fun, but man, the day one cheese is so real. I think Noctis might be a monster with the Okuzumi. Yeah, I agree. I definitely agree with that. That seems to be where his bread and butter is. Getting a knockdown and getting the most of it. I also think he's going to be great at holding a lead, but awful at comebacks. Once the gimmicks stop working, the one clear weakness he has as of right now, after watching a bunch of other people mess with him, is his lows are trash. Right? His best like low is pretty much Demolition Man, and I haven't even tested how fast that is yet. He has his own bootleg version of Demolition Man. And that, if you want like the comeback low, that's pretty much all he has, unless you want to rely on that spear, which we don't know if it's sealable or not yet. You know, we gotta wait to see how people, when good players get used to seeing that shit, how good is it really, right? Also, there's no crush properties on it, so it's not like Geese's down 1+2, which is kind of sealable, but at the very least, it crushes highs. So you get the bonus where if they happen to swing high, he'll go under and just chop their legs off, right? His low game is trash outside of that. So it's like, how is he going to open people up, right? But holding on to a lead, he seems amazing at that. Alright, and his lows don't seem to really have any counter hit properties except for the slow stab to the foot. So this is negative 14. This is 4-2. Right, this is high mid. 30 damage. Negative 14 block. How is it on hit? The spacing is gonna make this weird. How can I test this? At the wall? Well, let's try this. Hold on. We have a 13 frame startup move that has more range. Let's try that. Right? That's gonna move it forward. Alright, what I didn't test is... It does. Okay. So, you'll notice it does the nosebleed effect. So, they can hold down. I don't think he gets anything for free if they don't, though. If they don't hold down, he doesn't seem to get anything for free. Let's see. Like, no, she looks like she recovered. Yeah, no. I'm beating out the 13 frame move. That's negative on hit, yeah. Yeah, this might be a combo tool only. His dropkick does 50 damage. Yeah, he still lays dropkick, didn't he? Server Jibuto, I've come here to learn. Thank you for coming. If you have any questions, even if it's not Noctis related, feel free to ask. Yeah, this only seems good for combos because he teleports. I had a lot of trouble holding a lead with him today, so I was just playing Mega Keep Out. Yeah, I think Keep Out is where he excels. I got like a pain in my side, fuck my ribs here. His actual 12 frame punisher is like back 1-2, right? Which is more damage anyway. Alright, so it's hard to tell how negative on hit this is. Well, I got him doing jabs now, right? Ugh, I'm trying to mash, but I'm holding down. Okay, finally we got some meaty beats. Alright, let's try this now. Okay. -1. There we go. -1. This shit sucks. This was -14 on block, right? Yeah, okay. -1 on hits. Nosebleed. Teleport into air during juggle, right? This is a juggle tool, really. Next. Yeah, see, this is what it's really about right here. Those of you that don't know already, if you launch 4-2, he teleports into the air, and then you get an easy mode. You just mash 2 while he's in the air, you get an easy mode string that does a tailspin. So if you're new to Tekken or whatever, and you want an easy mode juggle out of his down forward 2, just do 4-2, mash 2, 4-4-4 when they land. Oops, I fucked up. Right? 5-5-5-4-4-4. And it goes into this automatically. You get 61 damage, which is like good for like hop kick, well, 15 frame damage. That's about like averages on 15 frame, maybe a slightly below average. It's really easy to do. If you're completely new to Tekken, you could use that as a placeholder. Until you learn the real shit. Which, I don't know what that is right now. Is it the real shit like, does it work off of this? No. How about, that ain't combo anyway. The down 2 to combo. Alright, well, I'll worry about that later. Alright, Cyclone Slash. This is like a fucking nightmare move. So this is homing and it's Tailspin, the corkscrew move. And you can cancel out of the first hit. Alright, so this... That's like a nightmare move, right? That's a fucking... Yeah, Lord, look at that range! It starts high, though. And then if you hold back, you cancel out of the second hit. Cancel standing. Okay. So this is a natural combo, right? Oh. I assume that would be launch punish, but I guess not. 13? 14. Wow. This is like the negative. This guy's like the -14 frame master over here. Bad matchup for against Brian. Brian fucks him up. 1+2. High mid. Alright, let's see how much damage. It's like 41 damage, was it? 41. -14 block. Homie. Screw. Homing, screw. Cosmo Canyon. Oh shit.
Hey! Hey!
Noctis has a couple nightmare moves. He feels like a Soul Calibur character. I agree. I mentioned earlier his 2-2. That's right out of Soul Calibur. I think that was, Not Lizard Man, but Aeon, Soul Calibur 5. His 2-2, well, BB was kind of like that. He went overhead and he stabbed. That was definitely a little spring from Soul Calibur. Alright, so we got high mid, right? Okay, the mid just knocks back for 28 damage. Yikes. Oof. So how fast is this? Okay. Down 4-2 crushes highs. Yeah, right. Okay, so this is very slow, as expected. Forward 3 is 17 frames, right? For Kazumi? Yeah. She got interrupted out of that. I got a little frame bot over here. Let me look it up real quick. Kazumi, 4 plus 3. So, off a jab, he interrupts 18 frames. Down 4-2 is going to crush the high, so I can't use that. Back plus 1. What's that? 20 frames start a bit slower, any faster. Kazumi, down back. This is going to be slow, too. That's way too slow. Kazumi. Forward 4, maybe? That looks slow enough. 16 frame startup. Cool, let's see. Okay, so 16 frame beats it clean. And scroll up. 18 frame loses clean, right? So that means 17 frame would exchange when he's in a plus one situation. That means this is 18 frame startup. The math right here, right? 18 frame startup. My 16 frame move beats him when I'm at minus 117. Yeah, 18. Yeah. I get mind fucked sometimes, even though it's simple ass arithmetic. I know. I'm an idiot. Sorry. But thanks for the help there, L2J. Alright, so yeah. 17 frame, a ton of fucking range. This might be yet another one of those long range punishes you can use against stuff like forward 2 from like Bear or Heihachi. Because if you're not sure if this is gonna reach, my other suggestion was this, but that's only 24 damage. So if you block something like a Bear uppercut or Heihachi forward 2, wait, sorry, not Heihachi forward 2. Heihachi forward 2 is negative 16. So this is 17. Bear uppercut, yes, Bear uppercut is negative 19. So some of those pushback moves, assuming they recover standing, you could do this if you're not sure you're in launcher range for 41 damage. So that's one good way to use this. And this is a long range with Punisher that homes, you know? The only problem is it's a high. And at the very least, it's only negative 14 on block, so most of the cast will not launch you for it. At the very least. So if you want to just kind of go for it and like, oh, maybe not randomly go for it, but try it as a whip punish. When you see something, if they happen to block it, you mistimed it because it's a little on the slow side. Not a big deal. Not as big a deal as getting this block, that is. Which is way worse on block. And it's more rewarding. And even if they duck the high, that bit is coming fast. Right, if I were to do one, if I were to record 1-2, right? If I were to try to interrupt. Yeah, good luck in something that would anything big. Yeah, you're gonna get like maybe a while standing 4 at best. Yeah. So it's definitely gonna be something that's probably gonna be blocked rather than duck and interrupted. So that seems like an okay move. I don't know if he could ever get that in a juggle. But yeah, so this is 17 frames. Okay, next on the list, we have the cancel, right? And I'm assuming this is going to be super negative. It's just there to play mind games. You want to be like Nightmare? He can't cancel into Nightstands though, but you know, whatever. Right? Is that at least safe? Yes, it's safe. It is safe on block. Damn. I wonder how that is on hit. Wow, that's cool. Okay, so it's not plus on hit. Oh, man, it's only negative three? Let me record that again. Oh, that was back one. Man, that feels like I got a good there. Yeah, negative three on hit on the cancel. That's pretty good. I feel like a lot of characters that have cancels like this, they're like in you could punish them territory. So it's like you really got to have your opponent respect the move to not swing. But in this case, he's actually safe. I've seen a combo where someone does one into one plus two and it works. I don't know what the whole combo was. Interesting. Alright. So what is it like on block? Oh yeah, I already have him recording with the jab. Right, so it's obviously gonna be worse. We know it's safe. Knee was 18, right? Yeah, so the knee is 18 and the knee interrupts him. So if I had 19, I'm pretty sure the exchange is because we know it's safe. It doesn't even make sense. So that's negative 9. So 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2. Back. 9. Okay, 17 damage. Wow. Can you convert that? Nah. Okay, you can't convert that. Down, not down back. I want to see if we can convert that. Nah. He might get a free grounded hit. Yeah, I just did. He recovers too slow. It might be free. No, it's not even free. Don't do it. Don't do it. Negative 9 on block. Negative 3 on hit. That's really good for a cancel, in my opinion. Alright. Alright, we got the warp strike. I'm assuming it's the same where it's negative 11. Let's see. It's the big whiff punisher. It does not go full screen. Like, there's a distance we can have where it actually doesn't reach. I already tested that. Oh, look at what we got here. This one is safe, unlike the version out of the string. See? There's a limit to how far he goes, and he always does the roll no matter what. Yeah, so this is what else you do have to time it. You can't just, like, you can't just casually be, you know, you have to be like, cancel constantly, so you block it just in case you're wrong with your timing. Constantly cancel your sidestep. I have practiced my stair stepping, so it's sloppy, but you see, you can get around it. Have a clean stair step, and you don't have to worry about straight forward twos hitting you, really. Unfortunately, it's safe. Alright. Oh boy. This is gonna be hard to test. Oh, well, whatever. Let's see what happens when I mash. Okay, so you recover standing, even though he's doing the roll. Okay, he definitely still recovers standing, even if I hold down. I just wanted to check. There's a handful of moves in the game where you hold down after doing them, you recover crouching. Mash that one. Yeah, so negative nine. The forward three still interrupts, but let's see what happens back here. Ah, we exchange, so it's like negative eight instead. maybe it'll be negative seven at best. I don't know. Yeah. Still, there's no way to make this like plus. That's for sure. Oh, the ivory cutter, I definitely will. By the way, if you scroll down, you'll see my YouTube. I've done this sort of run through with several characters. Although I was able to do a more traditional run through with those characters because I knew about like a handful of their data from past games. So I was able to go based on that and also use the RB Norway or Enotech and stuff. We got nothing for Noctis outside of other people have like research. So I'm just gonna, I figure I'll do my own research, my own testing. Have it recorded, so if I'm a dumbass and I got something wrong, people could call me a dumbass or whatever. I'll go, you know, go my own way. Alright, so this is forward plus two. This one is special mid. How much damage? 25? 33. Okay, 33 damage. Startup. What is the startup on this? I'm pretty sure this is really slow on startup. Yeah, see? My 18 frame move beat him when he's at plus one. So, what was the other one I was trying to test? I had a really slow move in my head before. We got that. Ah, here we go. This is 24 frames. Let's see what happens here. So he beats 24 frames clean. 20 frames. He beats 20 frames clean. I don't know if the lean back affects that though. So that's 20 frames. This is 18, so 19 frames? Wait, no. He's at plus one. He's at plus one, which means he beats 20 frames clean, which means 19. Oh my god, I'm getting the brain fuck again. Alright. He's losing to 18. So that makes this move 20 frames? Is that right? Yeah, it makes this move 20 frames. I think I'm right. My 18 frame move is beating him. But my 19 frame move, when he's at plus one. So, excuse me, my 20 frame move is losing when he's at plus one. No, we would be exchanging if it were 19. 18 frames? What's down for two? 18? 18, good. We got an 18 frame move. This is weird. Yes, I think this is a 20 frame startup, I believe. If my math is right. Oh shit, I minimized the game back. Hate playing in full screen mode. It's the 20. I'm gonna put that with a question mark because I'm kind of mind fucked right now since it's 1:40 a.m. and I'm going on fumes. I have negative 7 to negative 9. That's as far as I was able to test. Knock down on hit. Long range. Okay. Some of this nasty coffee. Alright, next we got the knee into it. Okay, so since it was unsafe in the string before, but safe when he did it by itself, I gotta test it again in every freaking string that he could do it at, right? So, out of the two string, it was negative 11. It's negative... Okay. Yeah, it's negative 11. So anytime he does it off the string, is it going to be negative 11? Is that what we're looking at here? At least he was in recover grab. So you can jab his ass if you have to. Okay, so we got that going on. Wow, he still gets punished even if he rolls in front of you like that. Interesting. Alright, so can he sidestep it? By the way, I forgot to test the tracking on his 4. Do that now. Oh, I did. I'm sorry. I did that before. I remember it. The 4-2 was linear to the left. Okay. Anyway. We know the 4-2 doesn't really track. The knee. What about this knee? Look at that knee. That knee does a nosebleed stuff. He does it on whiff. Aha, look at what we got here. Hold down. And it's a punish. I'm trying to get up and do something. Oh my god, alright. Alright, well, we need to go slower. It's gonna be hard to do this if you do the low. Seems like I could get 13. 14, maybe not so much. Alright. I'm asked to stand up and get 13 frames on him, though. That's interesting. You could sidestep it, right? Of course, you could sidestep the knee. Oh, that's a big whiff. Wow, he hit me off axis and whiff. Oh man, this move is trash in the neutral. What the fuck? Yep. Alright, so how fast is it? All right, so that is 14 frames, right? 14 frame knee. All right, at least it's safe. Fuck. All right. That was close. This knee by itself might be all right. Let's see. Yikes. Never mind that. Yeah, that's like negative 9. That knee sucks. I suppose if you want to hit somebody that's doing a counter, you can do that, I guess. could be a 14 frame mid Punisher, I guess? Is that what it was? It was 14, right? That's moving forward a lot. Yeah, 14 frame mid Punisher. That's a use for this. 39 damage. Okay, so it's not an awful move. Negative 11 block. Knockdown. 14 frame mid Punisher. And it's a knee. 14 frame mid Punisher, that's a knee. If you know, they can use as a anti-reversal move. Because reversals don't work on knees. For those of you that don't know. Like an Asuka, an opposing chin in front of you. Okay. Very linear. So far I have not found one tracking move outside of his homing. So far. Nothing tracks. This looks like a decent whiff Punisher. Oh, Jesus. So it's a 15 frame. Negative 11. Not bad. That is a big pause. Yeah, motherfucker. Oh, man. That big? Oh, gross. Oh, dude. Oh, 14 frame gap? Are you kidding me? Oh, excuse me. A 13 frame gap? Collide with 14 frames? Jesus. Why? He doesn't even get anything on counter hit. Alright, use this as like a juggle tool or a block punish tool if you have to. I mean, you don't need this. Down forward 2 is going to reach the same distance this is going to reach. So I'm guessing maybe for juggles. Outside of that, it's fucking shitty. What's the purpose? Why? You have another follow. It is a natural combo. It does wall splat, I guess. So if you land it as a wall splat, more power to you. And what was it on block in? It was negative 11, right? Yeah, negative 11. Damage. 15. Negative 11. Spin on it. That's what I call it, a mid wall splat. 15 frames. Piercing Spear, this is one of the big ones. By the way, forward 4-2, corkscrew. Right about that. So this is gonna be like a set of juggle tool. Screw. Next we got forward plus 1 plus 2. Mid. Plus 24 damage, I think. 15 frames. I thought this was 15. Ah, look at that. Already something wrong from what I saw in the chat. That's a 14 frame whiff Punisher? Shit. This move is really good. It's dangerous if you fuck it up, but this is really good. As far as for how bad it is on block, Oops. Block it first. Oh boy. 20 frames. So it would be... Four plus three. Okay, now that 1 plus 2 is 24 frames. Oh boy, that's a 24 frame. Oh yeah, there it is. I mean, you know. I don't know how bad this is on block, but it's at least negative 25. Can anybody think of any really slow moves that are like 30 frames? Slower than 24 frames. Okay, that would be crazy if that punished it. Shit. Yeah, that is a pretty slow move. 36 frames, that's a bit extreme, but let's see. Kazumi 2 plus 3. Oops. Kazumi 2 plus 3. 22 frames, that's too fast. Let's go with the other one. 1 plus 4. Hunting Hawk.
Okay. I'll test that after.
Yeah, that's too slow. 28 frames. That's a good one. Okay, so 28 frames, no good. But the late hawk kick, which is what, 25, 24? So we're starting to narrow the gap here. Looking at 27 frames or 26 frames. Anything around that area? It's back four. 19? That's faster than it looks. Shit. Back forwards was probably fast. Yeah. I don't really have anything. Alright, so, yeah. We're looking at somewhere between 25 to 26. 25 to 27. Negative 25 to negative 27. In that range. I'm just gonna type it as 25 with a question mark. Block. Question mark? Very linear. Holy shit, if I go right, look at that, I'm pretty much at his back, because he goes forward so much. Right? Guaranteed. Alright, this knocks down on normal here, right? Yeah. And I can hold back for that. Oops. Okay. And it has counter properties. Oh, wait. Okay, no. You don't counter that can hold back. So he gets a free follow up if you don't hold back. Yeah, see. progress. Very linear. Alright, next we got the roll. He has two options. That is roll. Crushes really fast. Not that fast. Okay, good. I don't have any situation where I put him at -5. He puts himself at -10, or sorry, -9, or launch punch four. -14. Yeah, he has what's up, Monkey Fun God? Yeah, he has like Bob's roll. He doesn't have a juggle starting low though. He has a low that gives him, I think, one free follow up. Maybe if he spaces it. He's like super far. Oh, he doesn't even recover crouching. No free follow. Well, sorry, no juggle. Maybe a free follow at best. Maybe that's guaranteed. Attack on 20 damage. And he has bang. And from my testing before, the mid there, you cannot hold back to get away from a follow up. So this is gonna be like a combo, right? Bam! See, it combos. No, oh, that's guaranteed, but it's probably gonna be more damage. 20 and 20 for 40 versus 39. Jump is so floaty! Switch sides! Look, he shocked himself. He shouldn't be using electricity on his water, man. Alright, that might be guaranteed. Alright. I hope this is a really cool use for this move. Like a good floor break. -14 yet again. Fucking hopkick sucks. Kazumi's hopkick is so trash. Alright, so 4 plus 3 plus 4. Roll 1. Mid. So 20 damage, right? Startup doesn't matter. -14 on the block. Knockdown. Free follow up. And then we have roll 3 plus 4. Low. Damage. first time I tried before. Now I'm like... That's guaranteed, I think. That's 20 damage, so it's probably like annoying to do when I could just do... Nope, not that. 20 damage, right? Same damage. Backflips, though. Alright, that's guaranteed, too.
Hit it while running. 1 plus 2. And down back plus 1 plus 2.
Both knock away, so just do down back 1 plus 2 for 40 damage. Of course, you can just do forward 1 plus 2 for 39 damage, one less damage. But it also knocks away. Yeah, it did. Yeah, if there's any sort of good Oki option, I don't know it because everything is knocking away. So if you wanted some sort of funky Oki option, you'd have to like. Not do the free hit, then maybe you could set something weird up. Like, what happens if I do this? Think if there's a way for him to jump over the opponent, land behind him, and do his back turn stuff, because he has that back turn juggle starter, but his jump is so floaty. It takes forever for him to go up. He hardly goes forward, so you're not really going to get behind anybody. Maybe at the wall, but mid-stage like this, it might be there. It will take a lot of fucking around to find it if it's there. Low is probably really bad on the block. Pretty low to the floor, but some of these hitboxes are okay-ish. He goes forward quite a bit, so it doesn't look like you'll be spacing this out to make it safe. Oh, wow, I spoke too soon. No punish on that one. Oh, no punish on that one. All right. Well, it's always going to be launch punch by most of the cast. Ooh, wow. But at the tip, we're looking at maybe negative 16. Second bot on this one. There it is. That's the no punish range. You can see because it pushes me back a little bit. See, but when he ends up in front of me, we know I'm good. But...
Kazumi has a slow while standing launcher. Her while standing too is 18 frames. So this could be 18 frames safe. While standing 3 is 15. So if you got like a good 15 frame punisher, while standing punisher, you're going to hit him no matter what. It ain't going to happen with my hop kick though, because the hop kick is trash, I'll bet. You know? When he's right in my face, it's fine. What do you know? One of the few times the hop kick is pretty reliable. So that looks like a knee. Let me see something. It's a knee! It's a knee! You cannot low parry this. Not that you should be low parrying, but you cannot low parry this. Okay. The extreme? Oh shit. Okay, let's see what the free follow-ups are. Probably the same. Already got it. Yep, that looks free. Obviously, there's no tracking on this shit. As long as you're not slow. Look at how linear. He's committing to the direction when he rolls. I don't think that's a surprise, but... Shield bash. This is his armor move. Only armor move? The second hit is only armor move. You're gonna go left, you better walk it. You'll get his rear at least. Did he get a few follow-up? He do. Yep, he gets a free follow-up. Nice. Camel back on that. Nothing special on counter. Okay. This shit is super
same thing as anything else. Down back one plus two. Your best bet for damage. Dot forward one is so low on the list here, isn't it? Corkscrew, this is pretty much Dragon Ball's dot forward one four, except the corkscrews. Pretty good. 13 frame mid counter hit string. See how the tracking on this dot forward one is. Okay, they hooked him up good. It tracks to his right side, just like Kazumi, so he's got some tracking on his poking at least. Is it negative one? Yeah, negative one. Ten damage, shitty damage. So slow or too fast for me to really do a good test here. 4-4? Nope. Plus 5. Not as good as usual. Good, even that negative two. Good. -5. Not bad. Only -5 on block. You can delay it too. Unlike that. I don't know if Dragon can delay it. You can delay his quite a bit. Look at that. Funny the second hit gave him a juggle encounter. Asking for too much, I suppose. But still, the second hit does a nice chunk of damage. 20-24 encounter. And if they were to hit your opponent out of the sky, you get a corkscrew out of that shit. Delay messes up the combo. Yeah, any delay on it, no combo. It is a counter hit combo. No mix up from down forward one. What's up, have a nice day. You don't need a mix up from down forward one. This is like Dragon Ball's down forward 1-4. This is something to have during pressure. This is something to stop people from mashing your down forward one. That's how you use this. So, it's fine. Like I said, Dragunov has the same thing. And it's just, and his is actually negative one, unlike Dragunov's, who's negative two. So he has the Dragunov string. He has it delayable. So you stop people from mashing during your down forward one pressure. Black, right? You get the knockdown with a nice chunk of damage to move. That's how you use this move. So yeah, it's a risk, but you know, you don't spam it. That's the point. So it's good. Very good. And it's nice to finally run into a tracking move outside of his own. Alright, next we have his 15 frame Punisher. Down forward plus two. His big one. This is starting to irritate my wrist. I got one of those anti-carpentine wrist straps. Right. That's 15 damage. 15. This is negative 18 on block, I think. Ooh, negative 20. Holy shit, this is worse than I thought. What was the move? Oh man, I keep forgetting the move. 24 frame move was. Okay, what's this? Okay, so he blocks that. So 20 frames does punish him, 24 does not. I don't know if I have an in-between in there. Yeah, he has a lot of range, really good range. This, for example, outside of the absolute most tip shallow block of Heihachi 442, it punishes it in every other range. Very good move. Very, very good move. But very risky. So it's hard to pinpoint exactly how bad this is on block, but I'm getting at least 20 frames on the punch right now. Juggle. Very long range. Wow, no hitting him out of the air like a light. Which he does. Alright, let's just attract him on this. No tracking on this. Yeah.
so slow. You can't do her 10 hit on the back. Alright. Now for 4-2-2. So that's a natural combo. Ooh, 13 frames, huh? Sorry, no, 12 frames. 12 frames? Excuse me? No, wait. 14 frames. Okay, 14 frames. I was about to say, 14 frames. Okay. 14 frames, okay. Okay. Alright, that 4-4 soon. Tracks to the same side as the, now 4-1. Oops. Not walk, okay. Oof, it's kind of... Yeah, it's kind of weird. I have to time it a little later, I think. There it is. I have to time it just a tad bit late. If I sidestep the moment I recover, it doesn't work. So that's some bootleg tracking. This gap is huge! So 17 frames on we'll be exchanging. 16 frame beats him out, 18 frame loses. Okay, but if he hits you, then it locks you down. Safe? Safe! Huh. Well, that's the trade-off for being floated. So if you hit him with the first two, and they get a little too match happy, you could fucking float them with the last hit, right? That's a reset if you whiff the kick. You guys can big boy jump out of this. Damn. If you don't suck like I do. Toopy side, toopy side. Oops.
face. That is hard to do. Or awkward, at least. Maybe not hard. There it is. 70 damage. Damage is really good. That's actually worth learning. What's timing on? Because you get some good damage out of that shit. Same thing as, what is it, the running 1 plus 2? Right?
Okay, so this is down forward. Plus 4, 2, right? This was 14 frames.
Jab the thing start to come out, so this might be quite a bit of an advantage on him. I don't have any, like, particularly slow moves. 1 plus 2? 17 frames. Plus 6 on hit. Plus 6 on hit. Down 4 to 15 frames. Yes, it is. 15 frames with a lot of range. This is safe. How safe? Okay, so it's safe, but it's heavy negative. Negative 8. sure that's next on the list. Yep. Problem is, you could interrupt that. Right? And then, of course, that one. Try to instant while standing four. If I were good at it. It seems like that the high hits on a specific frame that makes it. Oh my. Are you kidding me? Really? Really? Are you shitting me? You're gonna make the high not track? God. That barely hit me there. Oh, okay, this one's starting to clip me. Okay. Okay, I can't instantly sidestep it. But I'll never get half the fall for it. It's just if I get greedy, right? Oh, there it is. It's inconsistent. Might just be Kazumi because she's getting clipped every once in a while. Yeah, it's inconsistent, so she should just duck the second hit. Same as the Dark Form one. The Dark Form one for him. No tailspin on this one, though. Counter hit makes the third hit guaranteed. can't delay it. Can't delay it at all. Not the second hit. You have to commit to the strings. No delay at all. Okay. Not on the second order. Alright, now 4 plus 1 plus 2. Another corpse group. Alright, this is a slow. This might only be a double sword. Whew. Yeah, this is like a double sword. I want to use the sound of that. That's the same attack that comes out of his 1-2 string, isn't it? Frame to reach, but 14 he blocked.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist tournament, Peanuts, Noctis Lucius Kylum.
Noctis Lucius Kylum.
We need another infinite stage, man. Two infinite stages are getting boring to look at. And even then, you only use one of them. Giga's, you shitty ass. Fucking who are you swinging at? Swing forward. Punch straight, goddammit. Punches to his left, to fucking his right side. I hate that shit. You have any idea how annoying that is when you play this character and you're trying to like look at your jab range and shit like that happens? Like I shouldn't, when I swing here, I shouldn't be seeing my fist cover Noctis's head without him being hit. That tells me that he's swinging like crooked, like a fucking moron. Punching like this. What are you fucking doing? I can't think of any other long range 13 frame or faster move. That's 14. I guess the only other way to test this is at the wall, isn't it? Let's go do that now. I should have done that in the first place. Whatever, man. Don't judge me.
Get ready for the next battle.
Definitely wall splash, man. Okay, so this is sick. Looks like it's not much.
Okay, that's negative 9 probably. It's safe, but 18 frames is interrupting if you die. So it's gotta be negative 9. Fuck with people at the wall. Okay. Well, it is Kazumi, so above average sidestepping, but still. They go the wrong way. Bam! Wall splat, 23 damage. To see if some sort of weird wall shit would happen if I did it as a wall combo. You would be like put off axes or something. Down forward one plus two. I would just use that as a juggle tool. It seems slow. Excuse me. Down one. Alright, this is a key move. This is gonna be his, like, Alisa's, I don't know, his back one or back two. Like a mid poking move that leaves him ground, leaves him crouching on hit. So he can mix up his full crouch stuff, right? Question is, how good is it on block? So no matter what, he recovers crouching, right? First hit has some dragon on it. It's bad if it, but only the first hit hits you. Okay. Oh, wow. So if only the first hit hits you, it's an 11 frame punish. Yikes. Alright. Of course. Okay, so he beats out 15 frames. 12 frames beats him. So it's gotta be like negative 3 or 4 on block. Who's got this? Shaheen has 14 and 13. Shaheen. Alright, I'll pick Shaheen.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament, Shaheen, Noctis Lucis Kylo.
Yeah, while standing 3-3 for Shaheen, I believe is 13, and while standing 1 is 14.
Get ready for the next battle.
Saving? Wait, what? This doesn't make sense. Is this actually 12 frames? Hold on a second. Make sure I'm not crazy here. Oh, that's 15. That should tell me right there, right? He's beating out my, he's beating out my, 15 frame clean. He's losing to my 13 frame clean. So if I were to do a 14 frame move, I would exchange with his 11 frame move. Which means that's, -5. Brain is fried. It's like 3 a.m. If you were to exchange the frame over the 14 frame. That puts him at -3. Right? 14 frame move exchange for 11 frame move, -3. So -3 on block. Ah! Wake up! Okay. -3 on block. Right. Okay. I should have stayed with Shaheen, actually. Fuck.
Welcome to the King of Ice. Noctis Lucis Kylo. Get ready for the next battle.
My Noctis cosplay. you ain't gonna be seeing that from me. I'm too fat right now. I gotta get back to my dieting. It's hard, man. It's hard. I'm assuming that's 15. Oh. 17 frames.
That's 17, right? +4? Is that what I'm getting here? +5. Actually, Kazumi has it too. What are up against?
Noctis Lucis Kylum.
Oh, I picked it in the wrong direction. I gotta record games.
Welcome to the King of Iron. Noctis Lucis Kylum. Gigas.
Yes, it is, Mucky Funga. Try that, Link. It might work. It's just a bunch of random Final Fantasy music I just got through together. Anybody off the top of head know if negative 15 on block low? Wow, I think 28. negative 15. You got a negative 15. Oh, Feng. Let's see if this is actually 15 frames. I think it is, but you know, I gotta be sure.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist, Noctis Lucis Kylum, Fen Wei.
By the way, you guys, look what works now in the chat. Look who it is! It's the dead man himself. Okay. Confirmed. 15 frames. 15 frames. Good. Very nice. Okay. Good, 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 good. So that means it is definitely +4, right? Because I exchanged with 11. 11 frames? 11 frames. If only. If only.
Welcome to the King of Iron.
Dave Martin gets added to the game is the day I ignore everybody else when I play online. At least for a while. I would love nothing more than for Mario to be added to the game. Alright, my playlist ended. Let me switch to my FF14 playlist. I gotta start labeling these better because I never remember which is which. Okay. So I'm talking about down plus one. Now, I don't know how much startup it has, but we'll get there.
Kazumi Mishima. The damage number custom sucks.
I was hoping it would show real damage values, but it shows some random ass like 300, 400, 500 bullshit. That shit is trash.
Get ready for the next battle.
This is actually Dissidia, it's not even Final Fantasy 14. Yes, okay. Plus four.
I think it was negative five on block. Is that what I was saying before?
Better than negative five. It was negative four, right? Because, the 13 frame beat him out, 15 frame loss, negative four. Okay, negative four, block. It's late, guys, I'm sorry. Plus four hit, that's easy to remember. Recovers, crouch. On it, SSR.
About this move, right?
You sidestep right, and only the first hit connects, he's negative 11, right? As you can see, negative 12, it's hitting him, but it's not a punish. It's not a punish. Over here, negative 11, punish, right? 11 frames. On block, it's negative 4, force crouch, and on hit, it's plus 4, force crouch. Is that good enough for the low? That's the big question. Probably not. Not for that low, at least. Alright. So, if you go low after that on hit, you can be launched by a 15 frame launcher, it looks like. I mean, the hot kick would crush it, but it looked like it interrupted it to me. I don't know. Seducer, what's up? Find any cool frame traps? No, actually. He's not plus on block very often. I'm talking about a really important frame trap right now. this playlist not having FF10 on this circle. I'm digging it. I didn't have the FF10 Battle Fiend. I must have fucked up. I thought I added it. My bad. I thought I added all the Battle Fiends. So this right here is Force Crush at plus 4. The actual frame trap here to pick someone below is going to be the bit. The question is, what crazy-ass Miz does he have to counter him with? Also, he has the forward 3, Suni, as while standing 3-2. Right? It's probably the same speed also. Next, he has while standing 1-2, which is basically like Steve's Wild Man, but slower. I think this is 13 frames. It's definitely slower. Any good damage, you have to commit to like a lot of shit. Thing is, if they try to crush this low with a hot kick, this is gonna hit them. And since it's a corkscrew, even if they go like hot kick for the low crush, it'll float them out of the air and you'll still get a juggle. So if you want to come in, you go right into the lost ending 2-2. Thing is, how bad is that on block? Negative 14. Classic. It's like everything else from Noctis. Yeah. That will catch people ducking. And like I said, if you hit him out of the air, I'm trying to jump at the right time. Oh. Damn. Alright, well, maybe not. It might not happen. While standing, mix-up game isn't the best. You could just go with a while standing 4, I suppose, but the big thing would be the beat. Yeah, that beats out while standing 4. Cross jab exchanges. Damage in his favor. So down 2 is a key move, but his mix-up game from crouching isn't as good as I was hoping it would be. Sorry, down 1. Did I say down 2? I meant down 1. Alright, next is down 2-2. This is really more of a combo thing, but it might have some uses outside of that. This might be the reason you could maybe potentially do a fucking bootleg ass supercharge mix-up, because you turn that as a low into a combo for 37 damage. Of course, you gotta do that too. But that's a lot slower. Damn. And if the first hit whiffs and they get caught with the second hit. So this might actually have some uses. This is one of those. Like a capoeira, low into high, right? Don't shoot. Is that a blind monkey? What's up, Landonio? Landonio, would you like to add a Marduk avatar to your arsenal? Because I know you always come in here with weird ass avatars. Because I got one. Aram is dead. Down plus 2. Let's see what down plus 2 is like by itself. 12 damage. Yeah. severely lacking a low, so hopefully down plus two by itself is good. No tracking, damn it. Okay, it covers his no low parry. It's the sword. So first of all, no low parry. Second of all, oh, it's pretty bad on block. At least negative 18, as you can see. But no low parry on it. And it seems to track to his left side, which is what the down forward one does not track to. Unfortunately, that will only take you so far, because all that means is that you just sidestep right duck, right? You know what I'm saying? Oof. Kazumi actually has a interesting little trick here for OSs like this. Shit is actually quite difficult. It's starting to make me think that the low might be kind of fast. Maybe not. Maybe not. Okay. So. Okay, 20 frame low. Negative 3 on hit. So you could duck. And there you go. That's what happens if you try to interrupt. That was a wall standing four interrupt. After the low. You can't really delay it. Yeah. If you can delay it, it's not noticeable.
this stupid looking kid. It's okay, but it's super risky. It's like one of those like punishable with an asterisk lows because the high has you covered. At the very least though, it's not heavy negative on hit. Only negative 3 on hit, cannot be low parried, and you can kind of like clip it from here. And depending on the matchup, some characters might have trouble fully punishing this. Might. He does recover standing, so careful with that. But yeah, outside of that, this is like a pickup juggle for a lot of things. Like that, but really you wouldn't be using doubtful for that. Picked up for something else, was it? Well, I picked up for something else. It's always nice to have a low starting corkscrew, like Geese's back 4-4, because it helps you convert floats. Now, his might be too slow to do that. We won't know until, you know, people start floating, trying to juggle off of floats. Like, maybe it's a slide punish, right? If I were to... I mean, he has a while standing 4. He doesn't need that for a slide. His while standing 2-2 is going to slide punish, because it's going to be a corkscrew. No, never mind that. Still though. No, get the idea. Oh, this is just demolition man move. Alright. See what's up with this. Okay, it's slower than demolition man. Much slower. frames. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, Paul's demolition mat is 15 frames. So it's definitely unseeable. But don't let it get blocked. Awful block. One thing I did notice about this is you do need to be relatively close to trip, but not as close as Paul has to be. This is like a thing where if this were Paul and I were sidestepping right like this, it wouldn't trip me while it whiffed though. Another thing is the second hit is high. That's a problem. Yeah, see. Yeah, see. So. Interesting. This is an odd mechanic. I don't know how to explain this. Wow. What the fuck? This is weird. So, what's going on here is, even though that second hit is a high, if I hold down back to try to duck it, it hits me. But, if I just like hold back to block, I block it. I have to hold back though. You can see like the direction, but if I try to duck, you look at the arrow on the bottom right. See? I was holding down back. But if I hold back, I block it. Fucking weird. Oh, wow.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7, Gigas, Noctis Lucis Kylum.
Okay, so it's definitely jab punish bullies. Okay, here's another thing I want to test. What if I hold down back now? Yeah, the whole thing combos for more damage because it doesn't knock me in the air. So even though that second hit is a high, if the low clips you, do not crouch. Do not crouch or you're going to eat the whole thing for even more damage. That's such a weird mechanic. But if the first hit whiffs, then by all means, crouch under this dumbass and then launch him.
Death!
25 frames. Okay. So at least negative 25.
Low, high, mid.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Kazumi Noctis Lucis Kylo. Get ready for the next round.
17 frame startup on the low. Negative 25 question mark. At least negative 25 on block. Knock down on hit. I just realized something about this move. Hold on.
Get ready for the next battle.
Okay. We have a juggler starting low on this stage. A 17 frame start. Tracks to his right. Yeah, tracks to his right side. How's the last hit on block? Let's see. Force crouch on the last hit. So this isn't like a Demolition Man thing where the pushback fucks you up, right? This is just, it's gonna force crouch you when you get a launch of dumbass big stuff. Negative 18. I think of a much slower thing to do than that right now. All right. Interesting. People are. Oh, Bloodhawk is. Oh my god. There's some tech on Twitter being shared by Bloodhawk. Oh, Bloodhawk is getting blown up. It's not by Bloodhawk. We're talking shit because he shared some tech catches that weren't real, I guess. Damn, what the fuck? Subtle is showing some crazy shit, though. He's wall splatting. It looked like he's putting himself off axis, though. But he wall splat and did the 1-2 teleport in the opposite direction of the opponent tech. And he gets to their back. This shit. It looked like he wall splatted off axis, but he did this shit in the opposite direction. So you could go right or left with that. 1-2-4, 1-2-3. As the wall combo. And then they teched in the opposite direction, and then he hit the opponent in the back. That's fucked up. Alright. I'll go through that stuff later. I'm just trying to figure out basics of his moveset, man. So that's demo, man. Sherry, so you can check in the Discord there. About demo, man. Okay. Alright. Ah, mass killing me. Now I'm back 1-1 plus 2. It's nice. I think this is what I saw Anakin ending juggles with for a float. Yeah. Float something. Less than some death, though. Down back one by two. So it's safe. No tracking doesn't look like I have any track. Oh! Spoke too soon. Spoke too soon indeed. Track's right. Tracks right quite well. Only 7 damage. Frames. Yeah. negative 5. That's it. Wait, sorry. 0. Not negative 5, dumbass. I'm a dumbass. Sorry, guys. 0 on it. No tracking on this. I guess how my timing was off. Probably gonna want to do this whole string instead of just doing the first hit. Let's see how bad it is. Force the block, you cannot swing in between the hits. Damn, now it's tracking again? Track right with a question mark. Might be a Kazumi thing when I got around those couple of times. Negative 7. Pretty good, it's a good move.
Solid move to poke with, it seems to track, right? Natural combo. Alright guys, I'll take a small break here. Gotta go use the restroom and all that good stuff. But I'll be right back in a few. And I will continue this and hopefully finish tonight. So don't nobody go nowhere. I'll be right back. I'll leave the music going though.